Hello, Sairam students. Yes, today we'll be doing the last topic of chapter 2 in part 14. So today, in today's class, we'll be learning about the Bodmer's rule, the order of operations. Now, what does Bodmer's stand for? Now, we have learned about addition, subtraction, multiplication and division. Correct. Now, what does Bodmer's stand for? Bodmer's stands for brackets of division, multiplication, A stands for addition, and S stands for subtraction. Now, in this Bodmer's, of we will be learning in the higher classes. Rest brackets, division, multiplication, addition, and subtraction we'll be learning today. Now, when do we need Bodmer's? Why do we need Bodmer's? Now, you all know that when addition, subtraction, multiplication and division has to be carried out together. So, Bodmer's helps us to know in which order to do which operation first. That is, when you complete a mathematical number sentence involving several different operations, when there are several different operations like addition, subtraction, multiplication and division, then Bodmer's helps us to know which order to complete them or which operation to start with. Anything in brackets should be completed first, then the order followed by any division or multiplication, and finally we have to do with addition and subtraction. Now, what are the order of operations? That is, the first step what we have to follow according to the Bodmer's rule is, first we have to solve the brackets. The second is, we have to start with multiplication or division if it is there, that is from left to right. And then solve addition or subtraction operation, again starting from left to right. So what we are going to solve first? We are going to solve first the brackets, then the multiplication and division, whichever operation is there from left to right, and then the addition or subtraction, whichever is there from left to right. So according to this order, we will simplify the problem. Now let us see this example. Here it is. Simplify. We have to simplify this. Here in this first sum it is, we have to do division, addition and subtraction. So we will follow the Bodmer's rule here. So according to the Bodmer's rule, the first thing is we have to solve the brackets. So here we will solve the first bracket, that is 15 minus 4. Now what is 15 minus 4? 15 minus 4 is 11. Correct? So first we will solve the whatever operation is there in the brackets, we will solve the brackets. So 12 divided by 2 will remain as it is. 15 minus 4 is 11. Now in this one, division, the second one, division and addition we have to do. So according to the Bodmer's rule, we will divide first. So 12 divided by 2 is 6. And then we will add 11 to it, that is 6 plus 11, that is 17. So when you follow the Bodmer's rule, it becomes easy for us to simplify. So let us see one more example based on simplification. Okay, now according to the Bodmer's rule, we will solve the brackets first here. So first we will solve this equation first, that is 264 divided by 3, and then we will solve this one, that is 100 divided by 20. So when we solve this 264 divided by 3, we will get the answer as 88 plus 132. This we will keep as it is, minus 108 into 2 plus, now 100 divided by 20 will give you 5. Now, in the second one, we have to again solve the bracket first according to the Bodmer's rule. So 88, I'll write it here brackets, the second one 88 plus 132 will give you 220. Now we have solved this brackets, so this equation will write it as it is 5. Now in this one, according to the Bodmer's rule, now we will do the multiplication first. So we will multiply. Now 220 will remain as it is. Now 108 into 2 will give you 216 plus 5. Now here we have two operations to be done, that is one is subtraction and one is addition. Now according to the Bodmer's rule, it is to addition to be done, but when we go from left to right, we have the subtraction to be done first. So what we are going to carry out is, we are going to do the subtraction operation first. Okay, so 220 minus 216 will give you 4 plus 5. So your final answer is 4 plus 5, that is 9. So always, whenever there are two or three operations, start from left to right. Whichever operation comes first, that is from left to right, we will carry out that first and do the simplification. Okay, now children, hope you all must have understood how to simplify the given problem. Now let us come to exercise 2.7 of this chapter. That is, simplify the following problems. Now let us see that, take the C sum here, 9210 plus 648 divided by 8 into, in the bracket it is given as 2015 minus 999. So here I'll show you step by step how to simplify it. So in the first one, we will solve the brackets first. Now this part, when we solve it, in the bracket part, we get the answer as 1016. So in the next second step, there are three operations to be done, that is addition, division, and then multiplication. So from these three, according to the Bodmer's rule, we will do the division part first. So when we divide it, 648 divided by 8, we get the answer as 81. The rest of the numbers you will write as it is. So then in the third step, 9210 plus 81 multiplied by 1016. Here you have to add and multiply, two operations to be carried out. So according to the Bodmer's rule, we will do the multiplication first. That is 81 into 1016. And in the last step, what we are going to do is, we are going to add 9210 plus 82,296. Now when we add these two numbers, we get the answer as 91,506. Okay, now in this slide, again I have shown you all the steps together. Okay, here first what we did, that is we did solve the brackets first. We got the answer as 1016. When we solved the brackets first, we got the answer as 1016. Yes. Then in the second step, from out of addition, division and multiplication, what we did is, we divided the number. When we divided the number, we got the answer as 81. Now from these two operations, that is addition and multiplication, we have to do the multiplication first. So when we multiplied the number, we got the answer as 82,296. And in the last step, we have to add both the numbers. So first slide I showed you step by step. In this slide, I have shown all the steps together again. So you can just solve it according to this in your classwork notebook. Now coming to the next sum, the D1, 4709. Now here we have to do first, according to the Bodmer's rule, we have to do the multiplication first. Because we have multiplication to be carried out, subtraction and then addition. So what we are going to do is, we are first going to multiply this number and this number. Now when we multiply this number, we get the answer as 57,980. This subtraction sign you will write as it is. And when we multiplied this number, we got the answer as 9,480. And to that we have to add 4,709. So whatever I have underlined, now here it is subtraction and addition. Now according to the Bodmer's rule, it is addition and then subtraction. In this case, what we are going to do is, we will go from left to right. Whatever the operation, that is from multiplication or division, if it is there, you just see from left to right which operation you have to do first. So here it is subtraction and addition. So when we go from left to right, it is subtraction. So we will subtract the number first and then add the next number to it. So when we add it, we get the answer as 53,209. Okay. Now here the sum is 684 divided by 12 into 132 minus 32 plus 520 divided by 10. Now here what we are going to do is, first we are going to solve the division first according to the Bodmer's rule. So 684 divided by 12 will give you 57. This 132 we will write as it is, minus 32 we will write as it is, plus now here 520 divided by 10. Now here you can use cancellation method, division, 0 you can cancel, you will get the answer as 52. Now 50, here it is in the second step, multiplication, subtraction and then addition. So first what we are going to do is, we are going to multiply 57 into 132. Now when we multiply this number, we get the answer as 7524. After that, in the third step, we have two operations, that is subtraction and then addition. Now according to the Bodmer's rule, it is addition to be done first, but in this case we'll go from left to right. Whether it is addition or subtraction, division or multiplication, you have to see from left to right. Whichever operation it is given, you can do that first. Now here it is subtraction first, when we move from left to right, so we will do the subtraction first and then we will add it. So 7524 minus 32 will give you 7492. To that we will add the number 52. When we add it, we get the answer as 7544. Okay children, or you can do this way also, that is, you can add 7524 plus 52 and then subtract 32. Yes, you can do that way also, you will get the same answer. Coming to the next sum, G1, here 91,634 plus 3,625 into 4 is given in the brackets, divided by 10, minus 825 divided by 5, again given in the brackets. So when we follow the Bodmer's rule, brackets to be solved first. So we will solve whatever is given in the brackets, that is multiplication and then division. When we multiply 3,625 into 4, you get the answer as 14,500. Divided by 10, we will write as it is. Then this bracket, when we solve it, that is 825 divided by 5, we get the answer as 165. Now in the second step, when we do it, it is addition, division and subtraction. So again, according to the Bodmer's, it is division to be solved. So we will divide the number first. So when we divide it, you get the answer as 1450. Again, you can use your cancellation method. if you use, that is 10 if you cancel, you will get the answer as 1450. Okay, now 91,634 plus 1450 minus 165. Now here it is addition and subtraction. So as usual, when we go from C from left to right, addition to be done and then subtraction. So you can add the two numbers first. When we add it, you get the answer 93,084. From that, you will subtract 165. So your final answer is 92,919. In the last class, I have already told you to learn and revise the tables from 1 to 10. So today we will be doing the tables from 11 to 15. I'll read out the tables for you simultaneously. You also have to repeat it along with me. Okay, now starting with the table of 11. 11 zeros are 0, 11 ones are 11, 11 twos are 22, 11 threes are 33, 11 fours are 44, 11 fives are 55, 11 six are 66, 11 sevens are 77, 11 eights are 88, 11 nines are 99, 11 tens are 110, 11 elevens are 121, and 11 twelves are 132. Is it easy, isn't it? Yes. Now coming to the table of 12. 12 zeros are 0, 12 ones are 12, 12 twos are 24, 12 threes are 26, 36, 12 fours are 48, 12 fives are 60, 12 six are 72, 12 sevens are 84, 12 eights are 96, 12 nines are 108, 12 tens are 120, 12 elevens are 132, and 12 twelves are 144. Now coming to the table of 13. 13 zeros are 0, 13 ones are 13, 13 twos are 26, 13 threes are 39, 13 fours are 52, 13 fives are 65, 13 six are 78, 13 sevens are 91, 13 eights are 104, 13 nines are 117, 13 tens are 130, 13 elevens are 143, and 13 twelves are 156. Now same way, you have to learn the tables by heart. Now 14 times table, 14 zeros are 0, 14 ones are 14, 14 twos are 28, 14 threes are 42, 14 fours are 56, 14 fives are 70, 14 six are 84, 14 sevens are 98, 14 eights are 112, 14 nines are 126, 14 tens are 140, 14 elevens are 154, and 14 twelves are 168. Now the table of 15. 15 zeros are 0, 15 ones are 15, 15 twos are 30, 15 threes are 45, 15 fours are 60, 15 fives are 75, 15 six are 90, 15 sevens are 105, 15 eights are 120, 15 nines are 135, 15 tens are 150, 15 elevens are 165, and 15 twelves are 180. So students, you have to learn the tables by heart. For the orals also, it can be asked. So you have to be thorough with all the tables. Okay. Now based on this, now students, FA1 project we have already given to you before the vacation, correct? I think all of you must have done it. Those who have not done, it is just a reminder for them. Let us just take a quick look at the project what we had given to you to do. So if you have not done it, still those students also have not done it, please do the project and keep it ready. So the project was, that is, you have to write any 5 date of birth of your relatives or your father, mother, your brother, sister, any 5 date of birth, and you have to remove the space, or you have to put the numbers together. An example is given here. All the numbers, that is the date, the month and the year, you have to remove space and put it together, and you have to form the largest and the smallest number using all the digits which is given in the date of birth. Now, after forming the smallest and the largest number, the same number you have to put commas, that is according to the Indian and the international number system, and write the number name in the Indian as well as international number system. Just go through the example which is given here, and whatever date of birth you have, you are taking it, you have to just write it in the same manner, that is using without the space. Put the number together and form the smallest and the largest number, and write the number name in the Indian and the international number system. Okay, so those who are not done it, please have a look at this FA1 project. We have already given it to you, and keep it ready. Now, coming to the home assignment based on the board marks, simplify the following problems. 4 sums are given, which you have to do it in your homework part. So, follow the board marks rule and simplify the following sums. Now, be ready for your oral students. So, we'll meet you in the next class with a new topic, a new chapter. Till then, goodbye and thank you for today.